Get your backpack ready. It's time to brainstorm another trip. This week, in our whirlwind tour of the history of science, let's travel to the 17th century, the 1600s. I hope you'll make some meaningful and unexpected discoveries this week as we explore the strange new world of 17th century science. Our focus now is on the century often referred to as the Scientific Revolution, the century of Galileo last week, and Newton next week. This week, we'll explore the rise of mechanical philosophy, which was the idea that scientific explanations should refer only to matter and motion, because nature is like a machine or piece of clockwork. Though we have only a limited time to visit, we'll not be like tourists in London, Paris, or Leiden who seek fast food at McDonald's. Our aim will be to get to know 17th century scientists in terms of their own place and time, not just in terms of modern science. Mechanical philosophy has many ancient and medieval roots, ranging from the impetus theory of Jean Buridan to the construction of large medieval town clocks. But the success of mechanical philosophy in the 17th century came at the expense of traditional competing perspectives that saw nature as alive and perhaps intelligent on the model of an organism. These diverse organicist philosophies included the chemical philosophy, Renaissance naturalism, Renaissance natural magic, Hermeticism, vitalism, Neoplatonism, Aristotelianism, animism, and others. This week, focus on the interplay between mechanical and organicist philosophies of nature and the figures who advocated one of these over another or combined them in various interesting ways. What is nature like to you? Is nature more like clockwork, a machine consisting of matter and motion? Is there such a thing as inanimate nature? If so, then you are sympathetic to the mechanical philosophy. Or is nature animate, like an organism? In your view, does nature possess important characteristics of organisms, such as self-animation, self-causation, intention, or intelligence? If so, then you will be sympathetic to the various organicist philosophies. Or is your perspective of nature neither mechanistic nor organicist, but something else? What is nature, and how is nature known? As always, when we're planning a trip, we want to better understand what people in this place and time were up to. What are some similarities between 17th century Europe and our culture today? How might these similarities help us to understand science in the 17th century? What are some differences between our culture today and 17th century Europe? How might these differences pose an obstacle to our understanding of 17th century science? What do you think might be the chief barrier or prejudice that obstructs modern appreciation of the scientific revolution? What would you most like to discover about 17th century science this coming week? Please share your thoughts on these things. What are your starting assumptions?